Welcome! Today we're going to make this simple vehicle mechanic that is very easy to set up and to use. So first things first, we need to go ahead and add models and physics to our game. So once we have a simple model imported, this is from Kenny's Car Asset Pack, you can go download the link in the description. We also add a simple plane with some checker textures. There, now we have a simple ground floor and car. So we can add physics to this by adding passive physics to the ground and active to the car, set it to box for the collision, and now we can go ahead and add in some logic nodes. So let's select the car model, the vehicle, let's go ahead and add a new node trait, and here we can go ahead and start making our game with logic. So one thing we want to do is make the car move forwards and backwards, and then a second part would be moving it, because when we press side to side, we're not actually moving side to side, we're only rotating the car to be able to move forwards and backwards in that direction. So there are two main separate mechanics that I want to create. The first one, let's go ahead and create it, is moving forward. So when we get the W key, we can set it to the translate object node. Now, one thing we want to do is we want to get the object's transform, and from that extract the vector. So we get the vector of our object, and then we're gonna add some math to that vector using the vector math node. And we're gonna set that to multiply, because what we're doing is we're getting the object's transform, and we're separating out the vector using the look option. And this is going to give us a rather high value. So we have to multiply it by something much smaller, like 0.005. So it gives us a much smaller value to work with, so it works fine in our game. And now we can go ahead and see that our car is moving forwards when we press W. Now, one thing you want to notice is that, we are very solid. When we release our finger off the W key, it stops directly. So if you want to smooth it down a bit, let it go forwards a bit more before stopping entirely, we can use the tween node. So let's get the tween vector node. I made a whole video talking about tweens if you want to go check that out. But once we dump that in here between the vector math node and the set transform node, you can see we can control the interpolation method of how it's going to interpolate. And the duration, of course, we can modify it to our liking. And once you guys know that looks pretty good, there we go. Now we can just copy and paste that for the backwards mechanic. And what we're just going to do is to modify the vector math values to be from a positive to a negative, and there we go. So we can move forwards and backwards. Well done. That is mechanic number one set up. Mechanic number two is moving left to right. Now, to do this is the most easy thing you could ever do. We're just going to rotate a slightly bit on the Z axis, so 0.02 or something of that nature. And then to turn right, you'd want to do negative 0.02. And essentially we have our entire car mechanic set up. If you want to go even further, then you can also maybe stop the car from rotating if you don't have the W or S key pressed down. And to do that, in this case, we're going to use events. So what we're going to do is we're going to send out an event that says our W key or our S key is pressed down. So we're going to call this event turnable. So it means it's fine, one of our mechanics is pressed down, so we are allowed to turn left or right. And so we set that for both the S and the W keys, so it works forwards and backwards. And now we just need a listener event for the rotation. So let's go ahead and grab the on event node, set it to update, and obviously reference that event that we just created. But we need to create a is true method, because we only want this to be applied if it is true. So if our event is true and our key A is pressed, then it's going to allow us to rotate. And same thing for the right, except this one's the D key, obviously. And with that all said and done and set up, you can see we have a perfectly well and easy to control moving car that you can navigate around your scene. I hope you enjoyed this, a simple video. And as always, see you next time.